Well, it's finally here. The season 4 finale of Outlander is upon us, laddies and lasses. There's just one episode standing between us and our annual sojourn through hashtag Droughtlander. But first, let's talk about the menfolk of our show. There has been some amazing character development this season, mostly driven by the women in their lives, of course, and it would be a shame to not recognize that. So before Sunday rolls around, let's take a look at 5 characters who truly have become a man of worth. Ian. For someone who started the season as an angsty and traumatized teenager, young Ian certainly has done a 180. He's kept his boyish fascination with the world around him, but he's also learned how to become part of that world as an adult. He learned how to speak several new languages, how to adapt to different cultures, and how to be brave, loyal, and steadfast in his convictions. His family has noticed, and it's been quite a while since anyone has put the word young in front of his name. His knowledge of the Mohawk language and their ways is a vital part of the upcoming rescue mission. Will he continue to stand tall as a man? Or will the mission put him to the test? Roger. The man traveled through time and space for the woman that he loved. Even now, not knowing if she still loves him back, he fights every day to stay alive and get back to her. His and Bree's love story has a lot of parallels to Jamie and Claire's. If Roger and Jamie ever meet, and can then get past that whole awkward "sorry I sold you to the Mohawk" phase, we think they'd find a lot of common ground. That is also assuming that he can accept that Bree's baby may not be his child. There's a lot of trials still awaiting Roger, and we're hoping that his love for Bree will carry him through. Fergus. We've loved Fergus since he first sallied onto our screens as an orphan in Paris. He's definitely grown into a good man, one who loves his wife and son fiercely and bravely. He's also shown that adversity is what you make of it, refusing to give up even when others judge him for his missing hand. He led the Regulators to save Murtaugh, even after they overlooked him as a member. Now that he, Marsley, and baby Jermaine are heading to Fraser's Ridge, we can only hope this means we get to see more of him next season. Lord John Grey. Lord John is another character that we've had to reverse our opinion of this season. He's so deeply problematic for the Frasers, cropping up at the worst times in the midst of trouble, but his position and power also brings them an advantage. He is loyal to the family, protecting Jamie first at Ardsmuir, then raising Jamie's son William, and now protecting Jamie's daughter. Lord John may still have unresolved feelings for Jamie, but we've seen him starting to come to terms with reality. We've also been forced to admit, as Bree said last episode, that he is impossible not to like. Jamie. There is no one who is as loyal and steadfast in his love as James Fraser. There's also no one more likely to go overboard when he sees those that he loves in danger. He may be on a quest to save Roger, but he's doing it for Bree. He needs to succeed so that he can earn back her trust and her love. For him, rescuing Roger is the only way he has to prove his worth as a father to Bree. Let's hope that he's able to achieve it, for everyone's sakes. Episode 413, Man of Worth airs Sunday, January 27 at 8 PM and Stars. Viewers can also watch on Stars.com or the Stars streaming app. Be sure to check back here to FanFest.com for a full episode recap, as well as continued coverage of the show throughout the year.